Hello everyone and welcome back to episode 7 of Engines of Via. Today, as I said back in episode 5, we'll be looking at the Bud RDC. I honestly can't wait to edit this video since I love the RDCs. I tried to make the videos over 7 minutes long, but there is no guarantee since it's actually really hard to do so, as I've said before. It's kinda hard to believe that Engines of Via will be done after the next episode. I will do another series when I come back from Winnipeg, which I'm already back. But I have fun making these videos so far, and I never thought I would actually like writing and reading off of a script for videos. I have tried to make scripted stuff in the past, and it has always fallen through, since the scripts are so bad. But with Engines of Via, I knew that Via Rail needed to be put in the spotlight for once, other than Amtrak. Because I can now proudly say that I have made the first series with a Via Rail topic. With all of that stuff being said, let's get into today's episode of Engines of Via. The Bud RDC. So the Bud Company of Philadelphia rail diesel car is a self-propelled passenger car. The RDC is somewhat iconic when it comes to old-time passenger service. The RDC was used by almost every railroad that ran passenger service before the government companies were formed by Amtrak and Via. The companies that owned RDCs include Santa Fe, Southern Pacific, New York Central, Grand Trunk Western, Canadian National, and Canadian Pacific, just to name a very small amount. The RDC has different variants. There is the RDC-1, the RDC-2, the RDC-3, the RDC-4, and the RDC-9. I will explain all of these variants in this episode, but before we get into that, let's talk about the specs, shall we? The Bud RDC has two GM 110 diesel motors. They output 550 horsepower, although the RDC-9 only outputs 300 horsepower since it only has one GM 110 diesel motor. They have a top speed of 137 kilometers an hour and they weigh 113,120 pounds. So before I get into the passenger capacity, I actually have to explain what the differences are between all the variants of RDCs. The RDC-1 is just two cabs and passenger seating. The RDC-2 is combined baggage. The RDC-3 is a combined post office. The RDC-4 is only baggage and the post office. The RDC-9 is a passenger trailing unit with no cabs. Although it has no cabs, it does have the one engine. Now with all of that out of the way, I can now tell you what the seating capacity of each RDC was. So the RDC-1 was capable of seating 90 passengers. The RDC-2 was able to seat 70 passengers. The RDC-3 could seat 48 passengers. The RDC-4 didn't have a passenger section, as I said, since it was used for baggage and the post office. Finally, the RDC-9 could seat 94 passengers, a whole 4 more than the RDC-1. The cars/engines were made out of the iconic Bud stainless steel. The RDCs were pretty much the motorized versions of the Bud coaches. They were built between 1949 to 1962. Via's RDCs were taken from CN and CP when the company was formed in 77. I couldn't find how many Via took, but I can tell you that they still roster 7 of them. Canada is the only Class 1 country to still operate RDCs. The RDC began to be phased out in the early to mid 90s. But Via Rail kept 7 of them in service. They just underwent a complete overhaul with the Via GPA-30Hs. They no longer wear the Via Ghost scheme, but now completely wear a completely gray version of Renaissance scheme. Before I get into Via more, I need to talk about what some other companies did to the RDC. The New York Central did something unthinkable to the RDC. Back in 66, the NYC put 2 jet engines on an RDC to see what the top speed would be. The jet-engined RDC set the new land record in 1966 for the USA. She maxed out at 296 kilometers per hour. Back to more modern times and some sense. Via Rail isn't actually the only government railroad in Canada to operate the RDC. Canadian National owns a solitary rail diesel car. The CN Evolution RDC is used for, well, like the name says, it's used to evaluate. The RDC was not only in the USA or Canada, it was actually international. Countries like Brazil, Australia, and Cuba had RDCs at one point in time. I do know a short line somewhere in the USA just purchased and rebuilt a number of RDCs in the past year, but I was unable to find what company actually did this. I'm pretty sure it's actually a Genesis and Wyoming company, but I'm not 100% sure. But how about we get back on topic of the Via Rail RDCs? The Via Rail RDC at its height were sometimes used as a normal passenger car, but the Via RDCs mostly operated the Vancouver Island line. With this line being closed, Via Rail did not know what to do with their RDCs. From what I know, Via RDCs are now used only on the Sudbury to White River line. I have actually been lucky enough to catch four of the RDCs in tow back from testing in Sarnia. At the time of this video, I caught them 9 months ago. They are actually the reason I started getting more into trains and started railfanning much more. My goal is to catch the Via RDCs again at some point in my railfanning career. Via Rail was actually recently noticed for placing bids on, I believe, 16 retired Bud RDCs. The public had no idea why a Class 1 company was bidding on equipment over 50 years old. Okay, everybody, that was today's episode of Engines of Via. I'm really sorry that I haven't made an episode in over a month. I've been really busy and haven't been able to find the time to write the script and edit the video. I hope that you guys can forgive me for this. I promise I will try to make the next episode of Engines of Via one of the top episodes, especially since it is the last episode of the series. Anyway, I hope that you all enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next episode with the Bombardier LRC. But until then, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Engines of Via.